Thank you. Welcome to an evening of jazz here at Holy Cross. An odd evening of jazz here at Holy Cross. Usually the crowd here would be standing on their feet right now, cheering and applauding, yay. So we're imagining that. This is, as I say, an evening of jazz music. It's an annual event here that was stopped in its tracks last year by the COVID, but we're back. And all of these players have been here many times. I'd like to introduce each of them to you. On piano, Ben Cook. On guitar, John Wilkins. On bass, Peter Contremus. And on drums, Marty Richards. Normally, I would take more time to introduce them and give you each of their very specific and quite incredible credits, but I'm going to let you guess. I'm going to tell you a list of people that all of us have played with so that you can be impressed collectively with the skill of these players, not just as jazz players, but as musicians. Among us, we have played with Chick Corea, Queen Latifah, Dizzy Gillespie, John Williams, Joe Perry, Steven Tyler, Frank Sinatra, Aretha Franklin, Demi Lovato, and Idina Menzel, and that's just a few. That all of us, not all of us have played for all of those people, but we have all collectively played with them. Jazz music is an American music, and it's a peculularly American music because it represents a combination of two very distinct musical cultures and styles. The Western European music, the music of Mozart and Bach and Beethoven, tonal music that's based on the very famous major scale you all sang in the first grade, do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do. And that particular culture is blended, is mixed in with the music of West Africa, with its very distinct characteristics. And how did those two very disparate kinds of music meet? They met through 250 years of slavery in this country. And out of that, at the turn of the last century, came an instrumental improvisational music that we call jazz to this day. And the key word is improvisational. We made up a lot of the stuff that you just heard. And one of the early foundational musics that went into making jazz what it is blues music. That was a blues that we just played, a very technical blues. But blues goes way back to the early 20th century and even earlier. And we're going to give you an example of two forms of blues music. The first one featuring the great John Wilkins on the guitar, and the second one will be a little more modern version of American blues music. First of all, John Wilkins. Thank you. And that, of course, was the great John Wilkins and the great Peter Contremus. I'm just going to take one quick, very quick minute to tell you exactly what we're doing up here and how we're doing it. Every song that we play, including the very first one, and with the exception of these two blues, which we kind of all made up right on the spot, most of the music that we play up here is based on a particular song. A song that has a particular length, a particular structure, a particular harmony, and a particular melody. And from now on, we will always play that song for you so that you can hear the melody as it was written. Once we play that melody, then we extemporize on the form and the structure of that song. We use the same harmony that the melody is supported by when we play the melody, but we're always playing on a form. We're always playing on a structure, but we're making it up. And that making it up part, that improvisation part, is what is most unique about American jazz music. It is an improvisational music. And that improvisational aspect came from the music of West Africa. So, to give you an example, we're going to do a tune now called Fungi Mama. It's a Latin tune, meaning it's not going to be swing, it's going to have Latin rhythms. You'll hear us play the melody. It'll be recognizable to you as a melody. And then we'll improvise. And we'll be looking at each other to see who's soloing and how we do it. The whole thing is improvised. And when we're through, we'll play the melody again. And that will let you know that that particular piece is over. So here is Fungi Mama. do 8 bars. 1, 2, 2, 1. Thank you. That was Fungi Mama. And those, that harmony of that song, for those of you in the know, that was a 32-bar song. And the harmony, the chords in that song, were taken from one of the most famous standard songs ever written, in the late 30s by George Gershwin. It was called I've Got Rhythm. And I've Got Rhythm was the basis of many, many original jazz songs where the composers enjoyed the harmony so much that they made up their own melody, but used the harmony of that traditional standard song, I've Got Rhythm. Okay. Jazz music was fundamentally an instrumental music, although there were vocalists, as you will find out fairly soon. And so most of the innovative jazz musicians in jazz history were instrumentalists. And one of the most famous was a composer, pianist, and bandleader named Duke Ellington. And he wrote some of the most beautiful jazz standard songs of any era. And we're going to do one of those for you now. It's a great standard done by both jazz singers and jazz instrumentalists. It's called In a Sentimental Mood. Why don't you give me an A just to make sure? Close enough. Thank you. I want to take a moment to do this. Really quite spectacular. I mentioned that jazz is fundamentally an instrumental improvisational music. All of the great innovators in jazz history turned out to be players, trumpet players, Louis Armstrong, pianists like Duke Ellington, saxophone players like John Coltrane and Charlie Parker, trumpet players like Miles Davis, for example. But there were vocals as a major part of this music. The earliest blues singers, the most famous of the earliest blues singers, were all women who were recording in the 20s and 30s. And the first great jazz instrumentalist, Louis Armstrong, a trumpet player, was also a spectacular blues singer and vocalist too. So right now we are going to introduce you all, whoever you are and wherever you are, to a wonderful singer who's a student here, a first-year student at Holy Cross, is the recipient of the Brooks Scholarship. She's a Brooks Scholar as a jazz vocalist. And please welcome in your own rooms, wherever you are, a nice quiet hand for Rhiannon Hurst, who's going to come up and sing a couple of tunes for you.
One, two, three.
Why don't you announce it?
Okay. The next tune we will be doing is called All of Me. We hope you enjoy.
I was just reminiscing about the movie Peter Pan and Tinkerbell. And in the movie, if you have never seen it, I even forget why this happens, but Tinkerbell turns to the screen and asks the audience to believe in fairies. So we're doing the same thing right now. We are assuming that wherever you are in the vast ether, that you were applauding very heartily for Rihanna Hurst. So we're going to pretend right now. I'm going to say, ladies and gentlemen, let's hear one more time for Rihanna, and then we will have about 10 seconds of silence while you applaud your brains out at home. Ladies and gentlemen, one more time for Rihanna Hurst. Ooh, I could hear it. Okay. I'm also going to reintroduce everybody here in the band. We're going to do one more tune for you. But before I do, I'd like to reintroduce the great John Wilkins on guitar, the great Ben Cook on piano, the great Peter Contremus on bass, and the great Marty Richards on drums. And I'm Mike Monaghan, and these are my friends. And that's what it says on the program anyway. Our last tune is called Groove Merchant. We thank you for watching. We hope you enjoyed what you heard, and someday come back in real life, in real time, so you can see what the bottom of all these faces look like. Okay, this is Groove Merchant. Like a Killer Joe intro? A one, two, a one, two, Killer Joe.